Welcome to this week's Grazia TV, your Friday fashion fix of the best bits you might have missed. Alexa, Naomi, and Claudia. Yep, the British Fashion Awards were the biggest night in British fashion. So even though Victoria Beckham lost out on an award, she was still loving being there.
My highlight was being nominated. I mean, when I found out that I'd been nominated, I mean, I thought it was a joke at first because I've only been presenting for five seasons now. So, you know, being up against a brand like Burberry that's been going for so many years was just such a big deal.
There's no doubt Cheryl's an amazing dancer, tackling routines we could only dream of. So how to explain this bout of mum dancing with mini-me Cher? Oh no. Remember this.
Ish, I'm going to wear the jumpsuit made entirely out of Velcro.
Come me out of this.
Well, it turns out Bruno was based on real-life German fashion designer Harold Glucker.
Hi.
Who stars in his own documentary on air next week.
Some days wear very, very tight trousers. I can't understand it.
Yep, he actually is for real.
Designer. I'm Harold. Welcome into my world.
New movie, The King's Speech, picked up its first major awards at the British Independent Film Awards this week. And judging by the trailer, we can kind of see why.
My husband is, well, he's required to speak publicly.
What was your earliest memory?
I'm not here to discuss personal matters.
Well, why are you here then?
Because I bloody well stammer! Listen to me!
Why should I waste my time listening to you?
Because I have a voice!
Yes, you do.
Give that man an Oscar. Ever wondered what Jennifer Aniston's friends make of Angelina? Jen's BFF Chelsea Handler gave us some clues this week with this onstage rant.
She can rescue as many babies from as many countries as she wants to. I don't f***ing believe you, because when I look into a woman's eyes and she gives interviews and she goes, I don't have a lot of female friends because you're a f***ing that's why.
Ouch. We reckon Doctor Who's new assistant Karen Gillan is one of the most interesting new style icons this year. So what surprised her about the high fashion world?
I went to the Mulberry show this year and I'd never been to a fashion show before, so that was really cool. And it was really quick, that was quite surprising. I was sitting next to Olivia Palermo.
Oh, she's gorgeous, isn't she?
She was really glowing, actually, that's what I noticed about her. But yeah, they were all just like, cool, you know, I do this all the time, and I'm like,
oh. Next up, while Katy Perry's been showing off her latest latex number on The Simpsons.
That's right, she's into puppets.
Hubby Russell has been dishing on married life.
My cat's become a bit grumpy.
Really? You brought your cats from England?
I bought one cat. Right. My wife had a cat. Yep. We've bought a joined unifying cat to create one tribe. Oh. That cat lords it over the others like the spoiled child of a second marriage.
I see.
We caught up with supermodel Angela Lindvall, backstage on the shoot for legendary designer Donna Karan's new fashion fragrance, Pure DKNY.
I think Donna Karan is an amazing, inspirational woman, an entrepreneur, a mother. I think it's amazing that all of the ingredients are being sourced from different places, particularly the vanilla from Uganda.
And we find out what it's been like working with her son.
Being with him and being able to tell him stories as we were shooting and to just capture that moment between mother and son, I think was really beautiful for this shoot.
Cute.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Special Recognition Award goes to a true fashion icon, Miss Naomi Campbell.
Naomi Campbell was recognised for an incredible 25-year career as a top model at this week's British Fashion Awards. So let's take a look at some of her most iconic moments. The highs, the lows, quite literally, and the moment she got to dance with Michael Jackson. And she hasn't aged a day. And finally, you know it's Christmas when Mariah Carey gets her Santa outfit on. This year it's for new song, Oh Santa. So it's Happy Christmas from us and an early Happy New Year from her.
I hope you had a fabulous 2010. Welcome 2011. Happy New Year.
See you next year for Grazia TV Series 2.